Greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission is Operation Pandora's Box, and the objective is simple, steal a laptop. Now, usually when it comes to these missions are ridiculously difficult, and you never can steal the damn things, you just need to eliminate the entire base. And I'm expecting this mission to follow that same trend as well. Let's just go ahead and check it out. As a surprise, it seems very lightly guarded. The surface seems, undulated sort of, with a lot of crevasses and stuff, but I do not think it provides sufficient cover for us to exploit. Anyhow, mission, steal a laptop computer containing nuclear launch codes from an enemy base designated Objective Bishop. Execution. Black Widow will insert you approximately 450 meters south of Objective Bishop. Follow your GPS guided axis of advance, eliminating any resistance you encounter. Human resource intelligence reports that the laptop computer should be on the second floor of the building on the eastern perimeter. Once you have recovered the computer, proceed north approximately 450 meters to Objective Queen. In order for this mission to be a success, you must recover the computer and reach the top of the FARP. What? We are not only stealing a laptop computer, but we are also capturing a forward arming and refueling point? What? Where Black Widow will pick you up. That is most definitely an enemy pop, isn't it? So basically, we are looking at, missile attack helicopters in this mission, I would suppose. Air photographic reconnaissance shows the area to be moderately patrolled. Human resources intelligence indicates that you are likely to encounter two squads of infantry supported by light armor at Objective Bishop and one squad of infantry at the Equus Point. Yeah, I can see that. I can already see that this is light armor, right? So basically, we're gonna have to, I don't know, triple shot every enemy that we see. Or maybe pistols some machine guns will be working on them, but who uses them anyway? Allied support. Alpha team will insert approximately 320 meters east of Objective Bishop. They will advance westwards, attacking Objective Bishop just north of the building where the computer is reported to be located. Okay. Charlie team will insert approximately 450 meters northwest of Objective Bishop. Advancing southeast, they will attack Objective Bishop from the west. Once you have recovered the computer, both teams will advance with you to Objective Queen. Situation. A written communique from the general in command of rebel forces states that unless all allied offensive operations are halted as of 2400 tonight. 2400? Don't you mean like, I mean the last hour, the 24th hour, I get it, or you could just say, you know, 00 tomorrow. I don't know whether that is the correct way of using that 2400 tonight. Nuclear weapons will be fired at targets in the Russian Federation and Alaska. So basically, this is essentially our way of delaying that attack, so to speak. Intelligence has been unable to locate where the nuclear weapons are being stored. Human resources intelligence has discovered the location of the accounting line designators for those weapons. For the weapons, these are 5 character codes indicating ground zero and the command to strike for each warhead. Without the codes, it would not be possible for the nuclear weapons to be fired. The laptop computer must be recovered so that intelligence will have time to locate the weapons before they can be used. Well, that is good. I hope they have reliable information. No, I will not be using this. No, thank you. Not at all. This seems like a better weapon to be used in this condition. I, however, will stick to the M4. I don't know why we are being supplied with 2 laws here. Maybe helicopters are okay. I will still stick to double load ammo because the helicopters aren't that difficult to take out, especially when they're coming from a park. So let's just go ahead and start this mission already then.
Bravo, King 6. We have a trace on the package, somewhere north in the base.
Roger, King
6. Approach package with caution. It may be hot.
Yeah. So I tried playing this mission with the sniper as well, and while it was pretty amazing at taking out enemies, I missed the fact that you can lob grenades out of this machine here. So yeah, I'm just gonna stick to this gun instead. Thank you. And the fact that this has got far more bullets than the sniper, the Beretta decal will ever have. That also helps, sort of, on that ammunition.
Alpha 2 is hit! I repeat, Alpha 2 is hit!
Now, what I don't understand about Alpha 2 is how they can get hit so often.
Charlie 1 is down!
It's sort of like, you know, the mission begins and Alpha 2 is like, oh, I'm down, help me. Ah, that was rough. For my throat, I mean. Nobody asked, but the throat infection situation is actually getting worse. And yeah, it's not a lethal infection per se. It's just super annoying. It makes me cough randomly. That gets away from that, and this is exactly what I was talking about when I said going prone actually helps you suppress your how do I put it, profile, make it narrower, make it more difficult to hit. In this game, however, it needs to be combined with, well, cover, because otherwise, you know, bullets can literally go through it. But yeah, typically, you would want to lie prone if you want to, you know, avoid getting hit with bullets. It's amazing how, like, from a certain range, after a certain range, they literally tend to fly right over you. Anyhow, I feel like I sort of I'm getting lost here. Not exactly saying, talking the point, I mean, saying what I should be saying. Like, talking about what I should be talking about. Since I have, like, tons of bullets anyway, let me just go ahead and get you guys out as well. And I think that is most of the people on this map taken out. Two more people over there, left to be taken out yet. I do not know where I'm getting shot from, but I do know how there you are. Yeah, that's one of you, and since I have the bullet to do this anyway, let me just go ahead and do this. Like, I just love how you get, like, literally 300 rounds. Wait, actually more than 300 rounds. 300 rounds is literally standard carrying load. More than 300 rounds, I think. It's around the standard load is, standard ammo load, I mean, is like 30 into 13, which is what, like, sorry, my maths is a little bit, 390 rounds, yeah, that's like the standard load. With this, you get like, what, 24 into times 3, how much is that? That's like 75 minus 3, 72, 720 rounds of ammunition. But the moment you try to carry more than 80 rounds of 50 cal ammo, yeah, apparently it just suddenly gets too heavy for you. I suppose what's really heavy there are the hopes and dreams that are resting on your shoulders when you have a sniper on your on it. The expectations of an entire nation weighing down upon you. I'm just blowing the barrels up, and, you know, just for the sake of blowing them up, it doesn't really serve much of a purpose. The enemies that are supposed to be here are still here. They won't die just because they blow the barrels. It doesn't really do much. Like, it doesn't really do much at all. I would still like to go along this ridge line here, because well, it gives me a little bit more cover in case somebody decides to attack me from there. Like that guy over there, which I almost missed. And that just leaves that area with one more enemy. And a few more enemies in that area that I cannot see. Then just go and blow up this barrel as well.
Alpha to Bravo, in position on the perimeter. We'll take up the rear.
Roger, Alpha. Good luck. I just love having like this unlimited ammo hack with this gun here. There was supposed to be another person over here, I just can't figure out where this guy is. Anyway, I'll just proceed ahead. Hoping that he'll be able to make it to his funeral. Needless to say, yeah, I guess somebody's shooting at me from inside this.
This is King 6. Bravo, search the base. Alpha and Charlie teams provide overwatch.
Roger, King 6. Proceeding to the base immediately. After a bit of cautionary elimination measures. I still can't see that guy. There's like one guy who's supposed to be somewhere over there. But I think given the fact that he hasn't shown his face yet, it's highly probable that he is more comfortable hidden than...
Bravo, okay. You're closing the objective. Stay alert.
Roger, 6. Bravo will continue staying alert. I don't know why these guys shout as if they're women having an orgasm when the grenade drops on their asses. Like, do they really enjoy it that much? I do not think they do. Anyway, I just ended up using these grenades for this section of the map because, well, these grenades are just far superior in their firing powers. I'm just gonna shoot another one here. And, yeah, that seemingly takes care of a few more bad guys.
We got hostiles on our flank.
Roger. Anyway, the previous time I tried this. The game froze, so I just need to be a little quicker. And hopefully the game won't be freezing on my ass again. I can hear shots being fired, but I cannot feel them. So I'm just going to go ahead and assume that they're not being aimed at me. Maybe they are, they just don't have the power to reach me. And I'm going to proceed inside this base, battle now. Hopefully the game doesn't bug out again, like it did the previous time. Yeah, I can't even see.
Bravo, package is upstairs. Package is upstairs.
I can't even see where the
enemies
are.
Package, Bravo. You're running out of time.
Roger, King 6. I will devote my life to finding the package. Also, help me. Oh, there it is. Now let's get out of this building before it.
This is King 6. Move the package north to the extraction point.
Roger, King 6. Attempting to get out of this building ASAP. Objective Queen is behind me, I know, but I want to put some distance between me and this damn building before the moon freezes up on my ass again. And we can just take a knee behind this thing here. Or rather, get down on all fours and just pause the beam a little. And take the time to cuff. So there Apparently a few more people there, and I think there's somebody inside this bunker as well. Yep, there's one more person inside this bunker, and we'll take care of that guy in due time. Time to proceed towards the objective. Objective Queen, wherein we have to take out one final layer of enemies and successfully extract. Now, since we have come this far, I do not want to jinx it. I will be proceeding with this mission as cautiously as possible. There's somebody else over there as well. Yeah, that's like far easier to do. And I think at this point there are only 3 people left. Whoa, that is a lot of enemies. That looks far more than 6. On the map, it sort of looked like just 6 enemies, but sort of looks far more than 6 over there. Anyway, time to begin our assault on this base. There are enemies on top. I will take them off first before I decide to go ahead and take these guys out. Caution is the name of the game. And yeah, nothing's possible without caution.
Charlie is down! Charlie is down!
Yeah, I know. It happened right beside me. I'm right here, you know. I think we keep forgetting that. Now, how is this a forward refueling an arming point, I wonder? I cannot even see a helipad on here. Neither do I see any more enemies. I saw one there who has been neutralized. Hostiles neutralized. I mostly picked up a lot of these games while playing Rainbow Six, and I don't mean the new games, I mean the older games, because the older Rainbow Six titles were amazing, just way too amazing. There are some enemies below us, like directly below us, and yeah, they're coming up the hill right now. Thank you for coming. It was nice executing you. There should be a few more people right here, like I think right near the beginning of this thing. Maybe inside of this home thingy, like this hut thing. I cannot see them though, and what I would very much like to do is clear this area without exposing myself to them and risking the game hanging again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flank them from this area, from this side, and I'll only expose myself as a final measure so as to not one, risk exposing myself unnecessarily, and two, making it more efficient to eliminate them in the process. And speaking of, there's the helipad that we were talking about, that I was looking for rather. That's one of yous down. I think another one of yous is somewhere over there. Let's just keep moving along this plane here. I do not see a helicopter on top of that, and that is very heartwarming to me. And I suppose that's the end of them. And there are still 2 people inside of this thing here. I really hope that is not the Black Widow. That is the Black Widow and not the Gazelle attack helicopter. I'm sorry I'm having to pause the game, stop playing with so many intervals in me having to play the game because, the cuff issue is getting pretty bad at this point. It's at this point where I'm coughing a lot and it's hurting my throat. So I need to frequently pause to pretty much just take a cough and then continue speaking to them. This one last enemy is somebody that I do not want to. I really hope that is not an enemy gazelle, and that is in fact our combat helicopter. Now, the final guy inside of this base, I cannot seem to find him anywhere. What I will do instead is I will go closer and I will try to flush him out using. Hand grenades. Oh wait, I don't have any hand grenades. Maybe the grenade launcher, the 40mm grenades. Now, here's the funny thing. Of course, it's not gonna flush him out, it's like gonna flat out kill him, but you get the point. The operating principle of.
Black Widow to Bravo, prepare for pickup.
It has not. This area has not been cleared. Black Widow, proceed with caution. Yep, cleared. There is Black Widow right there. Whew. Let's go! Come on, Black Widow! I really hope that the game does not get bugged out again at this point. Because that would suck, honestly. Ooh, the game did not bug out too. So, one of the things that I've been most nervous about in this game is it bugging out in this specific level. And, yeah, I've been quite tense about that because it has happened to me a few times now. That I had, like, almost succeeded with my objectives, but since I was near the building, it more or less bugged out on me. And, yeah, even though this game is not meant for entering and clearing, that is exactly what we were supposed to do. Luckily, though, my antics with the grenade launcher more or less, you know, distracted the enemy so that we could flank them and take them out from the side instead of having to target them face on, which would have been like a total nightmare. Anyhow, 61 kills, I'm pretty sure Alpha and Charlie got a few of them as well. So that probably amounts to 70 soldiers on this map, which is pretty much the most amount of soldiers I've ever seen on any map in this game. So, excellent work, Bravo Team. Without the codes contained in the computer that you recovered, enemy forces will not be able to input the targeting information necessary to launch their nuclear weapons. Covert operations continue in the Russian Federation and the US to find those who supplied the coordinates. That's nice. US naval forces, I'm pretty sure they're gonna deploy Sam to one of those missions. Sam and what's his name? Kestrel. US naval forces have just captured one of three merchant ships carrying nuclear launch electronics to enemy forces. I see. High altitude surveillance aircrafts have followed the convoy to their destination. Unified Allied Command has made the destruction of the remaining electronic components your highest priority. Of course they have. So this unlocks Operation Storm Chaser. I'm pretty sure this entire campaign is going to close off with one final mission somewhere in this area, because this area seems underexplored. Could be this area as well, who knows. But yeah, Storm Chaser. They destroy the crates containing the enemy's nuclear launch electronics. So they said they have tracked the convoy to the ship and destination, but it says destroy the crates. I really hope it is not a naval convoy and ambush mission, or maybe like, you know, like a convoy and ambush mission. Speaking of, I don't think we've ever had one of those missions in this campaign. I think it was Uzbekistan where we had like two or three of them. Anyhow, we just need to clear. The next time we meet each other, we will be clearing Operation Storm Chaser. For today, Pandora's Box was, as I expected it to be, a little difficult. The mission itself was not that difficult. What was difficult was having to retry it over and over again because it kept getting bugged out, and the length of the mission was also a little long, combined with the fact that we had to proceed quite strategically, so to speak. Just a moment. Apologies for that, I took off cap. The next time we meet, we will be covering Operation Storm Chaser. Until then, thank you for tuning in today. Take care. Farewell, brother. Thanks.